licensing, you can be fined and jailed.
Cape Coral man was caught with two dead alligators in the back of that truck. Now he's facing a hefty price. FWC says the man pulled the trigger on someone else's property in LaBelle. NBC2's Megan Myers is explaining why he thought he could get away with it.
I went to Ronaldo de Souza's home in Cape Coral. He didn't want to talk on camera, but claimed he didn't know his actions were against the law.
Killing of the alligator, you've got a third-degree felony, and that is 5 years and possibly $5,000.
FWC officers say De Souza not only shot two gators, but he trespassed onto someone's property, armed with a rifle. Pam C., a justice studies professor at FGCU, says oftentimes in these situations, people don't pay attention to the consequences for killing wildlife.
They assume that because these creatures can be hunted during a normal season, that hunting them another time is not going to have serious consequences.
Statewide alligator hunting season runs from August 15th to November 1st. Alex Link, a professional animal handler, says there's a few reasons why people may want to hunt gators.
You have some people that want to use the skin or eat it. You have some people that are just afraid of it.
Even if it was hunting season, someone would need a permit to participate, and that wouldn't apply on private property.
When you start poaching the animals, it kind of gives everyone a free-for-all, and you could end up, you know, if everyone does it, you could end up, you know, really hurting the population of them.
Professor C says there's only one reason someone could get away with shooting a gator, out of season and without a permit, and that's self-defense.
These gentlemen cannot realistically claim self-defense because it was not on their property. They were somewhere where they did not belong in the first place.
De Souza's is now facing third-degree felony charges. Megan Myers, NBC2.